not be the most athletic, but I am a DIY queen.
My favorite exercise is what I call the peace plank.
I'm great at playing fetch.
Guys, so I have rage, you know. I have rage in this kind of the brain.
Check these bad boys out.
Another thing that's going to help me is my amazing sports abilities.
You can shake my hand and feel the flesh grip yours. I am simply not there.
Razor? No need! I use a knife to shave my leg.
I am not a very big fan of crowds.
I was born in October, so I think that makes me a Libra.
I really don't want anyone to hit me in my beautiful face. I'm also ready to hit people in their ugly face.
If I can outrun the police, I'm outrunning all the contestants there.
Some of my hobbies include hunting, fishing, and cow chicken.
I do have a full-time job at the gas station by my house.
If you even attempt to stand in my way, I will remember who you are.
She even spelled it right.
I'm a librarian, which means I choose not to read.
Are you ready for Trickery?
All right, welcome back to day two, season two of Last. Give it up for yourselves for making it this far. All right, great job, great job. We are here on my historic farm to play some farm-themed games to see if these contestants have what it takes to make it to day three. Patrick and I have come up with two games that will test their wits, their skills, their pig knowledge, and their canoeing and kayaking ability to see if they can make it.
So I'm actually like feeling really, really good. Like I obviously wasn't the best out there in the first two challenges, but I wasn't last, which is like the whole point. So I'm like feeling pretty okay.
I am really excited though, because today we're going to the zoo. I love the zoo. I love seeing all the giraffes and the elephants, and the cheetahs are definitely my favorite. So I really hope we see a cheetah.
Last night I found out that there's no villa. Triffany told me that there was a villa that we were all staying in, so there's no villa. So I'm kind of sad about that. But I'm very excited for the farm. I dressed up in my bestest hat and I think I'll fit in rocket.
So this first game that we're going to be playing is called Wrangle Them Piggies. These contestants, just like last year with the chickens, will have a big old circle on the ground. And they will be tasked with getting two hogs into this circle in the shortest amount of time possible. The contestant who takes the longest time will unfortunately have to go home.
Well, going into day two, I would like to think I was pretty cocky because I placed in both challenges last time and I found out that we were hog wrangling. And let me tell you, I love me some hogs, so I was super, super excited when I found out that that was going to be our challenge.
Now, a couple ground rules with the hogs. We don't touch the hogs, and we don't do anything that will harm the hogs. We want nothing harmed on this farm. These are my hogs. Don't mess with my hogs, you got it? Good.
I'm super excited for this day's competition with the pigs because I'm wearing my pig shirt and I'm gonna dab it up.
Oh my gosh, we have pigs back on our country club. I mean, we just have one of them and she's like a little teacup pig, but pigs nonetheless.
You know, love being outside, man, you know, laying down in the fields, listening to the clouds and the trees. So I thought I had a pretty good shot at some of these outdoorsy challenges.
So, just like always, the contestants can use coins to give themselves advantages or to give someone else a disadvantage. The gold coin will make a huge circle for them to get these hogs into. The silver coin, they can force someone else to wear a wolf costume, because believe it or not, hogs don't like wolves. And then the bronze coin will give them a slightly larger circle. Anybody like to use their coins from yesterday? Triffany, Austin, come on over here. Triffany, which coin would you like to use?
My bronzer coin.
Your bronze coin, perfect. You get a slightly larger circle.
I'll use my bronze coin.
Your bronze coin, you'll get a slightly larger circle.
Well, I thought the pigs are going to be hard to wrangle because, you know, they got a mind of their own. So I thought bigger circle would really help me out.
Well, this is perfect. How are you feeling about hogs? Have you ever wrangled hogs before?
Never.
Are you excited to?
Sure.
Great. Miss Autumn, you look like you've been on a farm before, have you?
Oh yes I have, I live on one.
You ever wrangled hogs?
Of course I have.
great?
Well, my first thought is I was thinking back to my hometown where I own two precious little pigs named Precious and Cupcake. They sleep with me every night and they clean my teeth. And so I was just really thinking back to my home and really getting passionate so that I could win for them.
Well, it looks like these contestants are ready and roaring to go. So let's get wrangling. All right, Megan, are you ready to wrangle some hogs?
I'm so excited.
Britt, are you ready to wrangle some hogs?
You know, I think so, man. They're nature's animals.
Raymond, Gemma, Sarah, Jimmy, Autumn Rose, are you ready to wrangle hogs?
Of course I am.
Go. Starting off with Carol. Go. Nope, only that's a heifer hog.
My strategy is to just be one of the pigs. I've never seen one before, but I think they're really cute.
Get those piggies!
This is a really bad zoo. Like, all I see is pigs and a couple chickens, and there was like a dog running around.
Come here. Just trying to call the piggy.
I kind of just wanted to attack them with love, man, you know. Let them know that, you know, I'm there for them.
I'm pretty well trained in the squared circle, so getting them in ain't gonna be too much of a problem.
This hog is far more stingy. Well, that was half a hog. You'd make a great farmer. A terrible sheepdog.
As soon as I saw the pigs in the farm, I felt a little lost. Like, I've never been on a farm before.
Oh, he's going after it. Done! And she's half in, she's not in. Oh, not a full in.
Well, my strategy in the challenge was to pick up my overalls and sort of swing them around and chase these hogs so that they would sort of think it was like a lasso. And so I thought if I could, you know, kind of scare these hogs into the circle, that would be the best option.
All right, just get me behind the hog, and she is done. She's a professional hog wrangler. She's missed. Done. Well, you didn't even try, and you were done.
Get in the ring.
He goes right around, and he's in. Full hog. One hog done.
I love those pigs a lot, but I don't think they love me. I don't think they reciprocated that love, man.
And Carol's in the circle.
I've never really tried to communicate with pigs before.
No! No!
She's very angry and she's done. Great job, Trippany. Done.
They said go and the pig was in the circle within seconds.
I'm not really a farm animal kind of girl. I'm more of like a domestic pet kind of girl.
Done.
My strategy is just to get behind the pig and like force it into the circle.
In time. And one hog. Maybe one hog. One. Yes, yeah! One hog. We are back after the hog wrangling competition. Some of these competitors were real professional hog wranglers, and some of them need some work. So, just like always, we have a first, second, and third, who we are gonna pass out some coins. So, for the gold coin, with a time of 3 seconds, is Jesse Slinkman. Great job, Jesse.
Well,
congratulations. Congratulations, you can wrangle hogs on my farm anytime.
Oh yeah.
After I got gold, I felt really good because I jumped from fourth to first within challenge to challenge, so my confidence was even higher.
With a time of 4 seconds, in second place is Autumn Rose Clark.
Good job, Autumn.
There you are, great job.
Thank you.
Once I got that silver coin, I was absolutely ecstatic. I knew that I was ready to take on the next challenge and beat everybody else.
And for the bronze coin, with a time of 6 seconds, is Everly. Great job. Great job. You can head back. And unfortunately, just like every other challenge in the show, someone has to go home. This is Patrick's least favorite part of the show. This is my least favorite part. But unfortunately, with a time of 3 minutes and 11 seconds, Brett Sunflower is going to have to go. You can meet me over here. Brett, you did a great job. The hogs love you. You just were a little too nice.
You know, I like to be nice to everyone, you know, free-spirited man, loving everyone. But unfortunately, they weren't loving me so much. So, you know, I love you all, man. You know, hopefully I'll see you guys soon. But, you know, take care, everyone. Good luck.
Well, you can go stand over there with the hogs.
Thank you very much.
Sorry, Brett.
Peace out, everyone. Once I found out I was last, man, you know, I was just... Sorry. Just thinking of all the people that I'd miss, man, you know? I wish you all luck, man. I'm really sorry I couldn't join you, but I wish you all the best and looking forward to watching you all compete in these challenges. After I go home, I'm thinking I'm gonna see my grandma, man. You know, she's one of my biggest supporters at home. I'm gonna go back to her and I'm sure she'll have a warm plate of sweet snickerdoodle butterscotch cookies waiting for me on the kitchen table, so I think I'll go home and, you know, hug my grandma, eat some cookies, and just live my best life, man.
Well, the fun doesn't stop here. We're gonna head to my pond and do a little bit of pond exploration. Let's go.
What's up, dude? When did you get here?
A little bit ago, just found each little piece of quiet.
It's the last day of summer, why don't you sleep in?
I feel like this year's gonna be different.
Hello, Asheville Whalers, and welcome to the first day of school!
Hey! You know my friend Lisa, she's down from LA.
See you, shut up.
Hey, so I really suck at Spanish, and I need to pass this class to graduate, so I was wondering if you could help me.
Really?
Cool.
Stop chopping! What? Hey, say Miller! Stop staring at your little girlfriend! Alright?
X. Girlfriend coach.
Hey, totally
hooked! Shut up, Skip! What the hell is this? A number!
She's mine! Got it?
She's here for tutoring.
Do you want to hang out with me after school tomorrow?
You're with your friends?
Where's
Is that him over there?
I can't get away.
Totally hilarious.
He's telling us out for her. Can you see that?
I'm gonna take your precious frolfing yard. When are you going to stop?
It over to the pond. Are you excited, contestants?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I'm gonna dominate the kayak challenge. I don't care who my teammate is, I'm rowing.
Perfect. Well, here we're gonna be doing a little bit of a twist. Today we are going to be implementing our first team challenge. Yes, today the contestants will be grouped into random partnerships as they complete this task.
I did not sign up for this competition with teams. I wanted to win on my own accord. I just hope that I don't have a stupid partner like Gemma or something.
I am so excited that we are doing a team challenge. This is a really good opportunity for me to go on a one-on-one date. I really hope that my partner is a boy. No offense, girls, I just don't swing that way.
They want us doing this little team thing now. Tag teams aren't really my thing because I don't like relying on other people. They let me down too often.
One partner will be in a kayak, kayaking across this here pond. They will in their kayak have a puzzle. They will kayak across the pond, and once their kayak hits the other side of the pond, they will give a puzzle to their teammate. This teammate will take the puzzle and put the puzzle together on the table. When the puzzle is complete, we will say time, and that will be their time. Just like last challenge, the team with the lowest time will both be headed home.
and the teams with first, second, and third will all receive gold coins, silver coins, and bronze coins, which means we'll have 2 gold coins given, 2 silver coins given, and 2 bronze coins given. Do we understand? Great. We're gonna get them into their partnerships, and then we will explain the coins on this challenge. Let's go. All right, we've got them split into their teams here, teams of 2.
Oh my gosh, I am so excited. I'm partnered up with
Nate Keith.
I'm a little nervous getting partnered up with Everly because she did hit me in the face twice in the last competition on the Battle Beam. But I'm hoping that we just get through it together and work on our teamwork.
And now we are going to explain the coins. The gold coin for this challenge, the team that decides to use the gold coin, they both can work on the puzzle together. So putting their minds together to work on that puzzle. The silver coin they can choose to use on another team to cut that kayak pedal right in half. So they'll just be rowing with one little rower like this. That's not very fun, it's a lot of work. Then the bronze coin, if a team decides to use it, they will get a picture of the puzzle to look at as they put it together, which would be a great advantage. So teams, would any of you like to use your coins? Oh, quite a few coins going. I'll go right here first, come on over. Mr. Keith, you will be using a gold coin.
Yeah.
Perfect. That means you will both be able to work on that puzzle. Thank you. Who's next? Come on over.
I'm using the silver coin on C and Alexander.
C and Alexander, you guys will only be using one side of your pedal.
So we gave the coin to Alexander and C because we just didn't really like Alexander's attitude. Like, he just didn't really give off the good vibes. And then C is horrifying.
Megan and Everly think they can hold me back. Message to everyone else, you silver coin me, it's not gonna matter. It's never going to work.
Yes.
I'm going to use my bronze coin.
Perfect. You will get a picture of the puzzle as you work.
I'd like to use this on Everly and Megan.
All right, Everly and Megan, you will get one side of your pedal to pedal with. Perfect. So, Megan, how are you feeling about having to go one side?
I don't know. I'm a little scared, but she's brilliant, and I think she'll do a great job.
All right, Mr. Carnival, same question to you. How do you feel?
His problem. You're rowing.
What, why am I rowing?
You are rowing.
I am not. Okay, I am rowing.
Looks like we're having trouble in paradise. Let's see how this all shakes out. All right, Sam and Sarah, are you ready?
Yeah!
Yeah!
And go! All right, here she comes out with a kayak.
Sam! Go!
I don't know a whole lot about Sam. She's kind of annoying, but at the same time, I'm gonna give her a shot because who knows, maybe she'll be good.
Look at you!
Sam is right on track. She's perfectly straight coming towards the land here.
I don't need a strategy. I've had so much kayaking experience and I have awesome upper body strength.
She has to hit the land before she can pass off the puzzle. And she has hit the land. And the puzzle's been passed.
Alrighty. Simple puzzle, but hopefully I'll be able to figure it out.
She's almost done with the puzzle.
I'm getting there.
This truly is gonna come down to time.
Sarah's pretty cool. I think we could have a good chance at winning.
Alrighty, just about to
end. And? There we go.
Time. See the carnival, are you ready?
Yeah.
Mr. Esquire!
I'm fine.
All right. They will be competing with the disadvantage. And go! All right, here he comes.
Come on! Get over here! Where are you going? Turn!
I'm turning.
Turn faster!
I'm going as fast as
I can. Get over here!
This man probably hasn't worked an honest day in his life. I'm scared that this man doesn't even know how to swim.
You understand that this takes teamwork, right, guys? And you have hit. You are a puzzle champion. All right, let's see if the carnival can do this.
Now what?
Mr. Carnival, are you struggling?
No.
It seems that you might be struggling.
Wow, this is riveting. Wow.
Yeah.
God, this is... Oh, I'm so entertained. Wow, guys, you come up with the greatest competitions. Wow.
And it's time.
I'm surprised you can actually put it together.
All right, Austin and Jesse, are you ready for this competition?
Yes, boss.
All right, you may begin.
All right, come on, bring it up.
All right, here comes Jesse. He's coming out a little bit straight. Looks like he might tip. But he doesn't have his wheel.
I've had a decent amount of experience kayaking before.
Jesse makes quick work of the kayak. He has hit ground and he has thrown the puzzle. Great catch! All right, Austin, do you think you can get this puzzle done? He has no idea that this puzzle is actually rated the hardest puzzle ever made.
After I was paired up with Austin, I was a little conflicted because, sure, he did beat me in the battle beam challenge, but I let him do that because he's 13.
Never made a puzzle before. I'm new.
So what made you choose the puzzler job?
I like puzzles. I'm pretty good at puzzles.
And you've never done one before?
No.
Jesse got the team off to a great start, but Austin seems
Austin
to be...
Austin is not doing too hot.
Come on, boss.
the puzzle didn't go so well.
Alright, looks like he's about halfway done.
Halfway done, that's it, over.
So close. He's almost done, he's right on the cusp. He's staying calm, which is half the battle. He's overcome, let's see. Done, time. Gentlemen, great job.
Well, back in grade school, they called me the puzzle master, but now I realize my friends were making fun of me and trying to make me feel good about myself.
All right, Nate and Tiffany, are you ready?
Yes!
Nate, are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, remember, you have used a gold coin, so Nate may work with you on the puzzle, Tiffany. All right, in 3, 2, 1, go!
Let's go, Nate!
Here comes Nate Keith around in the kayak.
I'm so excited for our date.
Let's go, Nate!
I got paired with Tiffany, which I was a little nervous about. She had been giving me weird looks yesterday and today, so I didn't really know what to think when first going into the competition with her.
He just has that like bad boy persona, so I am really excited to be able to go on like a kind of date with him and just get to know him.
And he has made contact. He may pass it off, pass the puzzle off. Now they may both work on the puzzle. Here they go on the show.
So, like, tell me about yourself.
I kill people.
You're so funny. At first, the conversation was a little rocky because we were focusing on the puzzle, but then I started asking him questions and I found out so much about him. Like, he's so funny. Like, he just kept being like, I'm gonna murder you. Like, that is so funny.
I'm a libertarian, which means that I don't actually read, so you might have to do the work.
Oh.
Something like that. Oh, purr.
You're almost there, team.
There goes that.
It's on.
Yay! Woo, we did it!
All right, Jimmy, are you ready?
Yeah.
Autumn Rose, are you ready?
Yeah!
All right, 3, 2, 1, go!
When I got partnered with Jimmy because he wears black all the time and I heard that he listens to rock metal music, which is actually worshiping the devil.
And he has made contact.
We got it, let's
time
go.
To puzzle. What's your strategy?
Outside in.
Outside in. Are you a puzzler? Do you do puzzles all the time?
All the time. But then as I picked up this children's puzzle, I realized that I'm not any smarter than a 5-year-old.
This is a competitor that has gotten a coin in every single competition up to this point.
The guy, host guy, was just standing there making us feel bad and slow, and so it kind of sucked.
Jimmy, how are you feeling?
I'm a little nervous right now, but I believe in Autumn Rose. We're a good team.
As far as like Autumn personally, like I think she's pretty cool.
Done.
Yeah.
Oh. Raymond, are you ready?
Yeah, eh?
Awesome. Jimma, are you ready?
I'm ready!
Perfect. 3, 2, 1, go!
Woo! Come on, Leaf Boy! You got it! Yeah! Woo! puzzles out, boat. Yeah, you go, it.
I feel so excited being partnered to Raymond. We're both from different countries in the US, so I feel like we'll have a lot to talk about. And he looks quite strong, and he has a leaf on his head.
And you are good to transfer. Jimma, put these puzzles together. All right, Jimma, what's your strategy here?
I think I'm just really going to use the edges. Oh my god, are you kidding? This is Peppa Pig. I literally love Peppa Pig. I watch it with my nan sometimes.
Remember, you can cheer on and encourage with no helping.
Okay, hey. Dial in, eh? You got this.
Jimma. Go, Gemma!
Yay!
We did so good!
Everything went okay, and I don't think we'll be last.
All right, Emily, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Megan, are you ready?
Yes.
All right, remember, you guys have a silver coin used against you, so you'll be using the half pedal, but you use the bronze coin so you get the picture of the puzzle as you go. All right, are you good? 3, 2, 1.
Unfortunately, someone did put a silver coin on us, so that, I don't know how things are going to turn out.
You got this!
Having the penalty, honestly, it really didn't affect me. I paddleboard quite often.
And you may talk! All right, get to work, Megan. Megan, are you much of a puzzler?
A little bit.
Hey.
Almost
done. Okay.
All right, and then it's time.
Yay!
Good job! Woo! I feel really, really strong about that. I feel like we finished it really fast, and seeing the puzzle was just a great lead.
We are back here at the pond. The contestants just did some kayaking and some puzzling. Now, in third place, earning the bronze coin, was Nate and Triffany.
Bronzer, that's the best one.
Right.
We got the bronzer coin. I am so excited, and this just goes to prove that me and Max are gonna be a great couple.
We got third place and got the bronze coin, or as Triffany called it, the bronzer coin. I'm not sure why.
Matt, I hope you're ready for a day full of flirting tomorrow.
The silver coin goes to Sam and Sarah.
Ooh.
Congratulations, there's yours.
Good job, Sam.
There's yours.
Thank you.
Perfect, good job. And then the gold coin goes to Everly and Megan. Great job.
Oh my god.
Grab it, here you are.
Thank you.
Yes, congratulations.
That was the first gold coin I've gotten this entire competition. I got a bronze for the pig, but like gold was just a whole new feeling.
I got a gold coin! I'm so excited to get my first one, and it was just really cool to work with Everly because we kind of squashed our beef, which is awesome.
I have an apology gift for Megan.
For me?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, you shouldn't have.
It said, I'm sorry for hitting you so many times in the face yesterday.
Oh, okay. Well, let's see what it is.
You wrapped it nice.
I'm really good at wrapping. A tumbler? Oh my gosh, how did you know I work at Starbucks?
Well, I mean, yes.
Oh my god, thank you. There's two of them we can share.
Unfortunately, friendship is not the only thing that's happening here today. Two of our competitors will be going home. And with an only difference of 10 seconds, Autumn and Jimmy, can you join me up here?
You are joking right now. You better be joking with me.
I'm not joking. This is not a prank. I'm not a prankster. I'm a farmster. Come on over. So we will be saying goodbye. Autumn, can you step a little closer? Thank you. We will be saying goodbye to Autumn and Jimmy. So Jimmy, do you have any words to say?
Well, it was kind of a tough competition. The puzzle was, like, really weird, so, like, it's okay. We tried our best.
Autumn?
I just want to say that y'all are lucky you didn't get tackled like the last people that tried to cross me on a reality television show.
Give it up for them.
Well,
out that I was last. I thought it was absolutely blasphemy at first. And I just... I'm sorry.
Like, I did expect to get a little bit farther, but looking back on it, I am pretty proud of what I had accomplished.
I am okay now because I found the love of my life during the pig wrangling challenge. His name is George and he squeals every single time he sees me.
Well, just like always, we have to move forward. Thank you all for visiting. You all did a great job. You're welcome anytime. Tomorrow they head out to the archery arena to play some archery games, and more people will be going home until they find out who's going to win this $50,000. Good day, everyone, and have a good night.